you have gathered here with me today so that I may tell you all an important story. It is the story of the prodigal son. And though at first it may seem like a simple tale, there is a lot we can learn from this story. I want you to listen closely so that we all might learn an important lesson about how to live a good life from the story of the prodigal son.
I am a loving father. I have two sons. We were helped by the couple of servants. We lived in a nice house. We're not extremely rich. As a father, I saved up as much as I could to make sure that my family would be supported once I was gone. We used to be so happy back then. We helped each other in everything we do. My sons helped look after the house and the farmland we own. We have sheep, goats, and cows. My sons assured me that the animals were always well fed and well looked after. I love my sons so deeply. Although they love me back, they were not perfect. All I ever wanted was to live a good life together. Until one day, my younger
son, yes, I am the prodigal son. I am someone who spends a lot of money that I don't really have. Buying silly things and is too fond of wasting money. I felt so ashamed asking my father about my inheritance too early to live the life I thought I wanted. But as soon as I realized all the money I have had been gone on buying fancy food, expensive drinks, attending big parties, and many other things that will not please God, I became so desperate. I even worked as a pig farmer in exchange for tiny pieces of food. But then I realized how blessed I am to have a family like them. I know that my father, brother, and I used to live a good life together. We love each other so much. And for this, I will go back and offer my services to my father and hope that he finds it in his heart to let me back into his home. I will ask for forgiveness and even beg for mercy. Oh my God!
Thank you.
for your brother has been lost and has been found again. He was dead and has come back to life.
I am glad you have gathered here with me today.